Hello, Ultimate fans. We are back for the second half of the All-Stars versus Vancouver traffic in Winona Park, Vancouver. I'm Topher Davis here with Rena Kawabata. The score is 8-3 right now. Traffic went on a tear, four breaks in a row in the first half, and now the All-Stars facing a large deficit as their offensive line is on. But what, just like we've seen all half, just missed throws from the All-Stars, that swing straight into the turf.
Looks like the All-Stars got a gift there.
Yeah, only three passes so far in this point. Two of them are turns. Walrus walking the disc up to the goal line. Looking at a pretty large cup, they seem to be fine letting the swings go, trapping it on that flick hand sideline. A floaty scooper, but Lisa Pekathley makes the play, keeps the disc alive. That's the type of play they're going to need to get them back into it. Tick come on the sideline. Traffic in a person, and Tick come trying to go for the round backhand. Foul uncontested on the sideline.
I think that's the first call of the game, actually. It's been quite clean up until now.
Normal gets it on the sideline. Cutter's working the live side. Pekathley gets it under. Looks for the backhand break. Nothing there. Johnson with it in the center of the field. Looks like they're transitioning in. Wow. Quite the window for Alika to Johnson to throw it to. She got it through. I think she was going for Walrus, who was making the upline cut. But no one finds a disc, and now traffic with 70 yards to go to start this half off with a break. Bearzan on the goal line, able to get the swing off. Waldman in the center of the field, goes back. Lots of yards gained on that flick. Oh, wow, Kate Scarth. Tough defense on the dump. She just takes it right out. And All-Stars a couple meters outside of the goal line.
I definitely don't like playing with her running two steps behind me. She's got some legs, got a motor. She's actually our one Canadian representative on this All-Star roster as well, Kate Scarth.
Well, that time it's the Oregon player Jeff C. Schaffner finding UCSB's Lisa Pekathley. And a couple turns from both sides. All-Stars able to get the goal. And it took some work, but I think they can be pretty happy in the fact that they're starting to make plays again, which is something that wasn't really happening in the first half. They were kind of hoping traffic made some mistakes. And that time, Kate Scarth just decides, you know what, I'm going to go out there and take the disc away.
Definitely, and I think we'd all like to see a little bit more of that from the All-Star team. We know what they're capable of. We know they have the throws, they have the legs, they have that grit on defense, and let's have this really exciting second half from the All-Stars here.
Well, All-Stars down 8-4. I've seen this comeback happen before.
Definitely. I think they have it in them, and I definitely don't discount their energy and their enthusiasm. We just need a couple fist pumps from Alika, I think.
There goes the pull from Sturt. Ning has it a couple meters outside of her end zone. Inside break. All-Stars sagging in the lane. A little wall on the cutters. But traffic, no problem just hitting the inside shots. They're now at half field, moving quickly. But a scuba attempt doesn't find the target. An opportunity for a break early in the second half. Steph Lim lays out, keeps the disc alive. Again, we're seeing them try to make the plays that they need to make to get back in this game. Becca Brereton on the sideline. She's in a high count. She's got to put it up towards the end zone. Two players there. And wow, Margot Sturt picks that one out of the air on a bailout throw from Brereton. Again, we're seeing the All-Stars make plays, and the first break of the game for the All-Stars cuts the lead 5-8.
You know, that was a very exciting play. The traffic defense there was right on the resets, not giving tons of options, and that big flick huck went up, and they made a play. That's what they're going to have to do for the rest of this game. Now, traffic's keys here are really going to be to just stay chilly, to stay very calm, collected, patient, move the disc up on that open side as we like to do, breaks if we have to, and not have to sort of force those high-pressure throws like that turnover with the scuba. We were having success getting through the All-Star zone with some breaks and some open side throws, and I think all we need to do is just rely on those, rely on our receivers, and I think traffic should have a nice easy offensive point here.
Right, certainly traffic's defensive line was able to rely on their receivers and move it down the live side sideline. See how their offensive line responds. Again, a junk, no problem for traffic. They moved it up three quarters of the field. All-Stars transition to person.
Traffic moving into their red zone here, end zone. Oh. And a great bid from Katie Hakita. Traffic throwing some great plays back, right back at the All-Stars there.
Yeah, the upline strike cut. They seem to have had a lot of success of the handlers being able to get in front of their defenders, starting from the backfield and getting all the way up in front for the goals. Traffic's first point out of half extends their lead back to 4 as the score is 9-5. I wonder if the All-Stars are going to... Their junk hasn't been working that well.
Traffic's breaks, breakthroughs, the IOs, the arounds are silky smooth, and we can find those all day long, and we're comfortable throwing them. If the All-Stars put a little bit more pressure on those throws, or if there was a little bit more aggressive defense on those handlers, if those throws were, the receivers weren't so, I wouldn't say they're wide open, but if those opportunities didn't present themselves as much as they do right now, I think traffic's offensive zone offense would have a little bit more trouble there.
Yeah, and I think there's especially something true about the team being in the lead seems to be able to deal with the zone offense a little bit, or a zone defense a little bit better.
Definitely.
Because they don't feel the pressure of having to score. They can take their time.
Definitely.
But the All-Stars offense certainly feeling the pressure. Walrus with the disc in the center of the field. Swings to Schaffner. Pitt-Cathley gets plenty of yards under, and she's looking deep to Johnston. Got a step on her defender. This floats, but Alika Johnston goes up early and makes a wonderful play. Again, we're seeing Alika Johnston downfield using her speed and scoring to make the score 9-6.
We've seen the All-Stars have lots of success on those sorts of plays. The swing, and isolate one receiver deep. They have the throws, they have the legs. They had a lot of success with it yesterday with Riot, and I think that's maybe the first, or actually there was another throw to Jesse Schaffner in the first half that was a wide open receiver. So the second opportunity where that play, which is I'm assuming what they're going to be looking for every time has actually led to a goal.
I think that was the first time in a while that we saw traffic come down in a person from the beginning of the point. I think for the All-Stars, that's certainly beneficial to be able to get into their flow that you would expect. They can do some called plays and not have to deal with battling a zone before they face the one-on-one matchups where they probably feel like they have the advantage.
Definitely. Traffic's defensive philosophy is definitely to take away that initial play, to take away those initial looks, make things a little bit more comfortable, and then transition out of whatever junk into their person defense.
Swing across the field. We see a slight junk look. Looks like poaching on the cutters upfield, and Michelle Ning blades it all the way across. Traffic down the center. Looks like they're going to transition to a red zone. Ning with the disc upfield. Hannah Leathers lays out but can't get it. It's reeled in by Kate Wary. And a nice hold by traffic. No turns, no problem.
That's exactly what we like to see from our traffic offense. Calm, collected, looking for those open throws, throwing to those that first open pass, and being very chilly around the red zone. All-Stars still have some room to make a comeback here with a score 10-6.
Right, yesterday they had a 12-8 advantage, so that seems like a pretty large lead late in the game, but Wright was able to bring it back. 4 points is just a couple momentum defenses away, and All-Stars are back in it. But they need their offense to do the job.
Let's see if this offensive line can figure out the traffic junk defense here.
Pull fielded by Schaffner. Up to Walrus, back to Schaffner. Able to get it around to Pekakley, whose defender wasn't even close to her on the sideline. Now Pekathley kind of stuck, swings it across to Titcomb, has a defender on her back, but able to reel it in the middle of the field. Swings the sideline to Schaffner. Schaffner, good pivots to get to Johnson on the sideline, goes up line, gets steps on her defender, goes cross field, doesn't see Hui there, but it doesn't matter, as it goes well past Kate Scarth.
The girl is fast, but definitely no match for Jessie Schaffner's big backhand rip going downwind. And there is a little bit of wind here. I'm not sure if you can tell on the camera, but it's going from slightly from right to left on your screen.
Well, here we see that live side movement just up the sideline from traffic. Now she's stuck. We able to get it. The reset backfield didn't get it very far off the sideline, but keeping possession again. Inside break gets the reset. Great marks and tight dump defense from the All-Stars, but able to get it off. And that one, backhand across the field, two traffic players there. Easily reeled in by Aaron Busson.
Aaron Busson on the backhand break.
And that's a break point for traffic, right?
Yes, I believe so.
Minor games to 15, unless it gets tied or time tapped later on.
11-6 in a game to 15. And the first break for traffic in the second half, it took them a couple points to get their first break in the first half, and then they went on a tear. We'll see if the All-Stars can keep their offensive composure, get their D-line back on the field, and try to start chipping away at that lead. Now the All-Stars are going to be traveling to Portland, Oregon tomorrow night, heading back to the United States. But what's in the near future for traffic?
Well, traffic will be at the Pro Elite Challenge in Aurora, Colorado this weekend. Not sure what our schedule looks like yet, but I know that we'll be facing some tough matchups again, which is very exciting for us. I will also be down there despite my crutching still post ACL surgery. But it'll be a really great tournament, I believe. Lots of really gritty games and lots of fierce competition.
Traffic getting a nice warm up for the tournament here. All-Star offense moving the disc upfield. Leathers stretching it out to Bekathley. She's got room in the end zone, and she's able to reel that in. Good movement from the All-Stars in that point. They looked like they had a lot of open field space for their cutters. The most open the field has looked for them all game.
Definitely. I think that's exactly where the All-Stars are going to find success, is spreading the field, really working the horizontal movement, but also the vertical movement. And Lisa Pekathley was just wide open there for that end zone score. They stay spaced and they stay disciplined in their spacing. I think they'll be able to make this comeback happen here.
It was $10 for adults.
Score is 7-11. 7 at the All-Stars, who are polling, desperate for a break to start clawing their way back late in the second half. Looks like All-Stars have their size on the field. And Margo Sturt and Beck Brereton.
How tall is Beck Brereton, actually?
You know, that's a great question.
She looks almost 6 feet from where I'm looking.
I bet if the viewers at home tune into the Portland game, I'll have that information. Not quite available in my early research, but very tall. So a slightly junk look, but it looks like All-Stars are in a man and stretching deep. I'm not sure if the disc got hit at the throw, but it sails out of bounds. No chance for the target. And Dory Franklin going to pick up the disc, place it on the sideline for a chance for the All-Stars to get a break. It's plenty of yards where the disc goes out of bounds. And two players on the dump where Titcomb was. And Titcomb calls a foul.
Looks like there was a little bit of a collision there. There was two traffic players. Catherine Hui and Lauren Kimura around Gina Titcomb there.
Violation by just about players started moving
here
before the disc got tapped in. Maybe they're too used to watching the professional ultimate. You can't move until the disc is tapped in, players. Still a violation. As we get set, disc is reset. Schaffner now with it, and she's going to stretch deep. Floats it up. Sturt is there. She's on the back of the goal line, but can't reel it in.
I think the wind just got under that just a little bit, just enough to force Margo Sturt to try to toe the line, and taking her eyes off the disc for 1 second.
Yeah, with a slightly longer field, she was going to be able to run that out. Titcomb tries to poach in the lane. It's floating. Schrader gets there but can't make the play. And quick movement afterwards. Hui, Mason, and finds Ware in the end zone. Traffic turns at once, but they're able to hold on the offensive point. Keeps a 12-7 lead.
Now, I'm not sure if you can tell on the video, but we have quite a nice crowd out here tonight. We don't have stands, we don't have bleachers, but we've got a beautiful hill at Winona Park here that everyone can sit on. And we've got a bunch of our junior U19 players out watching. We've got a bunch of the local club team supporting as well. And I'd say, what do you think, around 300 audience members here, Topher?
I'd say anywhere from 300 to 350. We don't have a ticket gate to get an official count, but we're right here in the crowd. It's always kind of nice to feel like you're part of the crowd action instead of up above and separated from where all the noise and the action is coming from.
Definitely. I feel the energy. I feel the passion. And every exciting play, there's oohs and ahs and gasps.
Home crowd happy to see Traffic with the 12-7 lead. The defense putting a zone on that was very effective in the first half. Walrus and Johnson. Johnson working it backfield. Leathers with it. And there's a foul called. There's going to be a discussion. Churchland probably saying she hit the disc, and I imagine Leathers' argument is that the disc was still in her hand when it got hit, probably not any body-to-body contact. But we have observers here in this game, and the observer is going to rule that it's a foul.
The observer upholds the foul call. Disc is back with Hannah Leathers, stall count one.
So All-Star is able to keep possession. Leathers centers to Normile. Normile back to Leathers on the sideline. They're facing a person, but we're seeing that tough dump defense.
Exactly.
And Joffrey comes out from the cutter defender, gets the poach. Now she has the disc on the sideline, moving it quickly just outside the goal line. Oh, and a missed throw.
I think that was just a miscommunication there between Jamie Clay and Deborah Waldman.
Yeah, Waldman was going up line. Looked like she had a step but had stopped the cut before the throw came out. All-Stars lucky with an opportunity to get the offensive hold again.
We'll see if Traffic can recreate that excellent handler defense that they had on the last point.
Well, Lim gets open downfield. Pekathy able to hit her with the flick. And Lim swings to Scarth and able to run that down. Lays out for the goal. Steph Lim, star Stanford player. She was their Callahan nominee this year. And is able to reel it in. Really working that vertical space as she gets the initial deep look. Resets the disc and just continues upfield with the yards that she had on her defender.
I love watching Steph Lynn play. I got to watch her a bunch on the U23 coverage in London as well. And she's a workhorse. She's just working her butt off to get open for every pass and working to break her mark and fake. And it's really exciting to see such a young, talented player with such a great work ethic as well.
With the All-Stars getting the hold, they get to 8. Facing 12 from Traffic. If there's going to be a late game push, it's got to start happening.
Yeah, I think it's now or never, Topher.
Jesse Schaffner to play.
We'll see how the defense is able to adapt. Schaffner pulls. Ning able to get a backhand under the foot of Franklin. Gets it back in the center. Looks like they're trying to work that break side a little bit more. And wow, trying to reset to Hui. She just clap catch drops it. Clap drops, I guess. And now the All-Stars, Schrader picking up half the field to go. Up to Stevie Miller. She's going to stretch it deep looking for Brereton. She's on that sideline. She's on the back of the end zone, and she can't pull it in. Had the space, but the disc goes out of her hands. A lot of things to consider, and catching the disc seemed to take a back seat for the line.
Laura Mason definitely putting the pressure on Beck Brereton in that catch.
Observer moving Mason more to the center of the field where the disc went out in the back of the end zone instead of the cone.
And a scooper over the top.
Now moving quickly. Ning in the middle of the field. Floats up a backhand. No problem. And Hui is wide open. The throw's off. She's not going to have any problem catching this one in the end zone. A hold for the traffic offense after one turn. Look like this. That might have been the time for the All-Stars to make the move. But a missed opportunity as Brereton couldn't reel it in the back of the end zone. And Catherine Hui able to make up for the drop that she had and get the goal. 13 facing 8.
Well, let's see if the All-Stars can punch this offensive point in. And they might have another shot at crawling back into this game with a few breaks.
And it's always so difficult for the All-Star team to be traveling. They never get the home field advantage. Yesterday in Seattle, when Riot was down, there was a lot of noise from the crowd, and I think that really boosted energy, injected energy into the Riot team. Here, there's no one in the crowd who's going to try to inject that same energy into the All-Stars. They're kind of out here on their own, mm-hmm. having to draw it from themselves.
What I do know is that all these girls are leaders in their own right, leaders on their college teams and in their club teams to some extent. And they have that mental toughness. They have that fire and that drive to be able to will themselves to win here.
I believe that is on the pulling team.
An offsides call on traffic. First offsides of the tour. We're going to see a re-pull. First offsides calls, just a re-pull. If they're offsides for a second time in this game, the All-Stars, will be the All-Stars, will get the disc at half field. That is no problem. Alika Johnson in the center of the field. Again, a slightly poachy defense from traffic. Still All-Stars able to get yards. Walrus picks it up with her left hand, one-handed snag in front of the defender, and Leathers looking for Picathley. Picathley can't make the play, had a good read on it.
It looked like maybe
looked like she wanted to call the foul. Might have initially called it, but she's going to chalk that up to her own mistake. She had a great read on it, and Picathley is a strong player in the air.
Could just be a little bit of that urgency to score those points and try to make this comeback, and just that moment of lack of focus leads to those drops there. And another one for traffic.
And Scarth attacks immediately. finds Carolyn Normile in the end zone. Carolyn Normile, one of the younger players on the tour, just a sophomore from the University of Pittsburgh. But even as a sophomore, she has quite the impressive resume, where she was the freshman of the year for the Ohio Valley region. And in her second year at Pittsburgh, she was on the first team all region and even the player of the year for the Ohio Valley region. So we haven't seen her do much yet in these first two games, but I imagine as the tour goes on, we're going to see a lot from her. And especially as her college career goes on, she still has a lot of time to make a large impact in the game.
Now, I haven't seen Jacqueline Verju out tonight. Is she here with us in Vancouver?
You know, that's a great point. It doesn't look like she traveled with the team. Jacqueline is from Seattle, so maybe she had things to take care of at home. We're going to be going back through Seattle to get to Portland, and then we'll pick her up for the rest of the tour.
She definitely was an integral cog in the All-Star offense yesterday in the Riot game. The girls definitely got the whole package and speed and throws and defensive ability.
Right, one of those amazing type of players who is very big and very strong in the air. But when you see her throw, it looks like she could be a handler for any top team in the nation. Very impressive watching her in London for the U23 team. She made the U19 team last year, the U23 team this year, and will probably make the U23 team again in 2 years when they continue. Not even a freshman, going into her freshman year at Dartmouth next year.
You know, I should feel scared or intimidated or worried or something like that, but it's so exciting to see those types of all-round athletes coming into the game and making a huge difference in the women's game in Ultimate.
Oh, and a deep look. It's floating and a miscommunication.
It looks like Kate Wherry was just coming under there when Lauren Kamara looked to throw it deep.
Well, the All-Stars have been getting their opportunities to get the breaks. Here they are again. Hopefully they can take advantage. Dory Franklin able to get a big swing to Brereton and trying to get it to Schaffner. Players down on the field.
Candace Chan with the D block there, but then ran into her teammate, Kate Wherry.
It looks like she's a little shooken up. Probably no bodily injury, but a big mental block. When you knock into a player, you got to take a second to remember where you are.
Definitely. Candace is not unfamiliar with hitting the ground hard. She's definitely become known on our team and across the women's ultimate division as being someone who just sacrifices her body and at any cost. And unfortunately, you know, knows the first names of paramedics in Vancouver as a result.
Michelle Ning comes in for Candace Chan. No substitutions from the All-Stars. Disc gets tapped back in. Traffic, who started this point on offense, still has possession.
Michelle Ning didn't have a mark there.
Wow. Schaffner nearly makes the play. Probably frustrated herself for getting blocked in the first point. But she's got a tough time facing Catherine Hui in the end zone. Traffic now at game point, 14-9.
I don't know of anyone who can match up against Chewy in the end zone. She just has that next level gear that she can get to so quickly, and there isn't anyone on our team that can effectively shut her down like that.
Yeah, besides the speed, she was able to get her hand out there That's one of the more difficult things to do, to really get those extra inches by having to put your hand all the way out. You know, you'd like a nice two-handed secure catch, but if you can snatch it out of the air with one hand, those couple inches make a big difference. Yeah. 14 serving nine. Traffic will have at least six game point opportunities starting now.
You know, I'd like the All-Stars to make a little bit of a comeback, but I'm still rooting for my home team and my own club team. Hope Traffic can pull out this win. But it's not done until it's done, Topher.
One of the nice things about games to points. And again, a junk look, trying to force them to the forehand side. As Normal and Titcomb working backfield. Now finds Bekathley on the sideline. She continues up the sideline to Leathers, gets a toe in. Now up to Walroos, picks it up off the ground and able to get an easy throw in. Megan Cousins was just keep on creeping back behind the defenders.
There were two throws that were highly contested there with Traffic defenders right on the All-Stars' backs, and they came up with them both times, which meant that then they had an open receiver in the end zone.
Well, All-Stars make it to double digits. 10 facing 14. Traffic's O-line working their way onto the field. And interestingly enough, I don't believe I see Catherine Hui on the O-line.
You're right, she is not out there.
You'd think you'd want to have one of your top goal scorers in for an important situation. But this is also a great opportunity for Traffic to let some of the other players try out some stuff. They have some wiggle room.
Definitely, and I think that's exactly what our coach, Jeff Cruikshank, has decided to do here is, you know, give some of our younger players, some of our rookies, an opportunity to show our team that they can get it done too.
Berzan with the disc. Swings to the sideline. A side stack with a lot of open field space. And a foul called.
Foul called, no contest.
As Schaffner was rushing down to get the pressure on the dump. Laurel J calls a foul and then continues up line, but disc goes back. Tough situation, but J able to get the swing in the center of the field. Still working that flick side. Has a deep look, goes for it. Two defenders there. And Stevie Miller able to knock it away.
I think that was just too deep, too late for that opportunity there.
Scarth on the sideline to Schaffner. Schaffner tries to stretch a backhand deep to Margot Sturt. Doesn't get more than 3 feet off the ground. 70 yards for the Traffic offense to punch this goal in and end the game. Scuba swing. Now to that backhand side. Tough time getting it upfield. Contested on the sideline. Another scuba going around. Seems to be easier than the backhand right now.
Yeah, the All-Stars are putting on some great no-around marks here. Unfortunately for them, Traffic is well-versed in scubers.
There's the backhand around. Jay in the center of the field. Keeps going around. Jay back in the center. Now they're working that flick sideline again. Can't hit the upline cut. Back to the middle of the field. Little by little, they're getting the yards, and Jay takes a shot to the end zone. And that's no problem. Reeled in by Jesse Bell. And traffic ends the game on their first game point opportunity. Quite the game by traffic, taking it 15-10.
It was very exciting to watch my team with all their successes, both on D and on offense. Also very exciting to watch the girls in yellow, the All-Stars, just showcase their speed, their throws, their all of their talents. I know that traffic was very honored to be included in this tour and definitely loved the opportunity to play against the All-Stars. Bunch of very talented women who will go on to represent Ultimate, and especially Women's Ultimate, for years to come.
Yeah, and traffic made quite the statement at the U.S. Open earlier this season, continuing with a strong win here. We'll see what they could do this weekend in Colorado. The All-Stars, they're going to be moving down to Portland, Oregon for their third game of the tour. We had a great time on our trip here. International, our first and only international stop. Of course, this was all done with the help of the crew, our camera operators, Tyler Cable and Angela Toki, instant replay operator, Suni Haley, our director, Vin Bowie, and the executive producer, Kevin Minderhout. Always a pleasure to have around.
Thanks so much, guys.
I've been here with Rena Kawabata. I'm Topher Davis. Thank you for joining us. And we will catch you in Portland, Oregon for the continued coverage of the All-Star Tour.